So here we have Ivan modelling a balance pack. In fact, it's the model he used on the Te Araroa, a 3,000 kilometre walk in New Zealand from the top of the North Island to the bottom of the South Island. So he's very experienced at carrying and understands all the concepts very well. So you want to turn side on, Ivan. You can see here the slim profile of the pack and the balance pockets on the trail. These would be filled with the very heavy things, and this with your light bulky gear. So people have some common misconceptions about balance pockets. And first of all, you might think you can't see your feet when you're walking because you've got stuff in front. So turn around on it. So this is the reason why we have two pockets, and you can see your feet when you're walking. So we use these mountaineering, very rough terrain. It's not a problem because of this design feature that you can see your feet. And you can also adjust the gap between the pockets at the bottom and at the top, because if they're too far apart at the bottom, when you swing your arms, that's it. If they're too close at the bottom, then you won't be able to see your feet. So that's all adjustable. Next objection we get is, well, it's going to put more weight on the shoulders. Now, a backpack is always putting weight on the back of the hip belt, and these are putting all the weight in them on the front of the hip belt, because the connection to the shoulder straps is actually a sliding connection. You can see that? So that means all the weight there is going onto the front of the hip belt. So we're distributing the load evenly around of the hip belt, evenly around the hip belt, in a way you can't do with a backpack alone, which is always putting the weight on the back of the hip belt, and the hip belt tends to want to pull into your tummy as the hip belt slides down your back. So the next common misconception is you're going to get hot. So this is why we have an air gap between the body and the balance pockets. And the balance pockets are actually just attaching to the pack at the shoulder straps and at the hip belt. Now, what about men who have a big beer belly, or women have big butts? There is a frame in these balance pockets, and the frame is actually what's transmitting the load in the balance pocket to the front of the hip belt. That can be bent to shape your body. So you want to bend it. If they're actually touching your body, you want to bend it so there's that air gap. And it doesn't, the bigger the air gap, the more they're hanging away from your body. And that's an advantage in terms of your weight distribution, as long as they're stable. You want those to be stable. Now, the next objection is, if you're doing some moves and you're up against a cliff face, we wouldn't use these for technical climbing, but often in a tramp or general walking, you'll come across a situation, say by a river, where you have to step round a boulder and you need to be close to the face. So these are designed to unclip here and to pivot around to the side, and you can even keep that done up if you want to. And just, you can put your hands above like that and do the moves you need to do close to the face, and then when you've done those moves, you can re-clip. So you can see this is a pivoting connection, this lower connection. Now, you'll also notice that Ivan has clipped these chest straps. Rather than just clipping the sternum strap together like that, and clipping the balance pockets together like that, you can see that would be quite unstable. And also, always a sternum strap is actually putting pressure on your chest. But if you cross them, like this. Not only are they much more stable, but also they don't touch your chest at all. So there's no pressure there. Now, Ivan, we want to see how these move when you move your body, like you put your shoulders up and down, how the balance pockets aren't actually restricting your movement. Let's see, I'll just adjust this a little bit here. So we've got even tension on both sides. Now, if you can lift up your arm and then lift up the shoulder, so we can actually see how this is moving, this cord. You can see how that cord is moving, and also this can move here. That's good, you can see that. Now, do some movements with your hips, so we can see how this cord is moving here. Let me just tighten this up a little bit more. So you've got a separate cord, head belt movement, and if you can sit, yeah. So just sort of as if you're, you know,
booging.
Yeah. Always dance with my own pack.
Yeah. Can you? I hope you can see how it's all allowing that movement. You're not restricted in the same way. And another advantage of that is if you're held in a sort of straitjacket sort of situation with the pack on all day, you get a build-up fatigue in the muscles in a way that you don't if you, every now and then you can move your body freely and just release that tension. So it all works together to give a much better experience of carrying a load all day, a long day.